Hello, this is Vern, and if you've ever recognized at the end of a painful relationship that you could have avoided the whole thing, had you recognized some early red flags when you stepped into it, well, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you the five biggest red flags in men so that you can recognize them and avoid them for good going forward. Hello, this is Vern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the kind of quality man you can as a direct result of stepping into the most alive and the most feminine version of yourself and without the use of gimmicks or manipulative techniques. The problem when you enter a relationship and you want it to work, and especially if you have strong chemistry with a man that you're connecting with, there's a high likelihood that you can forget or push down or ignore or not see some of these red flags. So I'm gonna lay them out for you so you can recognize them earlier on. The first one is controlling behavior. Controlling behavior would be that jealousy that you feel is so cute at the beginning, but that could underscore the fact that the guy wants it his way and that he wants to control the way you connect with other men, with your girlfriends, who you spend time with, how you dress. Because, I mean, if you notice, like, there's a difference between somebody saying, you know what, I don't love that dress, or don't wear that dress. There's a big difference in those statements, right? There's a difference in saying, you know, your friend Mary or your friend Joe, I think there's something off, like, you absolutely cannot see your friend Joe, or you can't talk to your friend Mary anymore. There's a difference in controlling behavior versus concerns about your well-being relative to the human beings that you spend with. So some of the ways control shows is in the way you dress, in who you connect with, in your whereabouts. And the biggest sign of control is typically someone who is willing to dictate how you're to live your life, but has a double standard that has nothing to do with the way what he's asking of you is not what he allows you to ask of him. So just be very on guard for someone who wants to tell you what to do, how to do things, all in the name of your protection and your well-being. Second would be an incompatible life vision. An incompatible life vision would be where the guy shows you in the way he acts and the things he says to you that he wants a different finality in his life than yours. He's going for a different goal or set of goals. He has different values than you do. For example, he might not be at all into family life, and that's something that's very important to you. He might not want children, and that's something that's very important to you. He might not want marriage, and that's something that's important to you, or vice versa, right? You want to make sure that when he shares things about his vision, that you open your eyes and that you don't just think, well, we'll talk about this later, or he'll change his mind, or my magic will help him recognize the truth of life, because it probably won't. He has a set vision of life, and your job is not to convince him that the vision should be yours, but to align to a guy who has a similar life vision. Third one would be a guy who is emotionally abusive. Now, the controlling behavior is an example of emotional abuse, but it's not the totality of emotional abuse. Emotional abuse would be where someone takes it upon himself to manipulate you to his benefit, to shame you to his benefit, to connect with your vulnerability and then exploit it in a way where you feel less than him, where he wants to put you down, where he wants to ignore you, when he wants to do the thing that knows will hurt you the most. So if, for example, you share with him that you have this big fear of abandonment, and sometimes just to mess with you, he will not answer his phone or his text, and sometimes will disappear for a day or two. In the meantime, you might be going insanely crazy, thinking something happened to him, calling family, relatives, even the police, and then the guy shows up again like nothing happened. And he understands that he was messing with your spirit. He was pushing you down. He was doing the worst thing that could happen to you if that's the biggest fear you have. So emotional abuse, the problem with that is that sometimes to the untrained eye, untrained, let's emphasize that, because if you have a trained eye, you can recognize emotional abuse as easily as you can recognize physical abuse. For a lot of women who have not grown up in healthy families or feel really connected to the guy, they will actually come up with excuses as to why the abuse is not really abuse, but just he's caring, or it's not that he's a controlling mofo, he just loves me so much and he wants to protect me. It's not that he wants to punish me is that he had an abusive childhood, so how else could he act but that? I understand him. So emotionally abusive human beings sometimes get the pass based on some unreasonable standards that guys who, for example, punch you in the face wouldn't get, because punching you in the face would be clear, direct, not subjective, it's very objectively abuse. It's just called physical abuse. Emotional abuse, sometimes it's harder to spot, and that's why asking for help, getting coaching, getting training, or therapy, in some cases, is important. The next one will be honesty, right? When a guy has to lie to you about things that are inconsequential, it begs the question as to if this is something that's not important and he's lying to me about it, what will he do when he needs to share something where his ass is on the line, where he stands to lose, where the relationship could be shaky if he shares something that's not cool? You can't trust someone that you see not being transparent, not living in integrity, and sharing little lies about things that are of no consequence. Fifth red flag has to do with commitment. The life that he has, the actions he takes, the commitments in his life can show you if a guy is heading into the direction of more commitment versus commitment foe that save a giant miracle from the Holy Trinity will not change his ways. So what does that mean? Well, if a guy has always been single, has never committed to anything, that's not necessarily the best flag, although guys can change. But if he's not committed to anything, to anyone for a long term, and he's not doing anything beyond himself to help somebody else, that's also a sign that he may be just more about himself right now, either because he's narcissistic in principle or because he doesn't have the bandwidth, the capacity, the emotional intelligence, the generosity, the extra time, the extra whatever to put himself outside of himself and benefit. So you want to look for guys who do more for others, not just for himself, who have committed to something or someone for a long period of time, and who have the willingness and the yearning to push commitment, right? I mean, the guy doesn't he doesn't need to have children, but if he's never had children, he's never had a pet, he's 50 years of age, he doesn't volunteer, can he commit? Yes. Will he commit? Most likely not, right? Because when somebody wants to commit, his lifestyle changes in ways that shows you that he's more about something bigger than himself. That's what commitment is. A commitment and a sacrifice to give more of yourself to somebody else. So that would be the fifth one. Now I'm going to share two bonus ones just because I'm super fun today. The sixth one is, and that's one of the most dangerous ones, is the red flag that you push under, right? The one you push under is the one that you understand. There's something iffy, something shady, something doesn't smell right, something feels not cool, but you don't bring it up out of fear of breaking rapport with a person or out of being punished or out of being thought of as someone who is insensitive. So the one you push under is typically the one that hurts you the most. And then the last one, which by far will be the number one red flag that I see women being hurt by, is the one you miss. The red flag that you're not aware of, the one that you didn't have the training for, the one you didn't have the education, if you want to call it that, to understand that it's something that could hurt you in the future. So that's why learning about red flags, learning about healthy relationships, understanding the skill of love, which goes well above and beyond the feeling of love, is such an important part of your well-being. Here's the thing, most human beings take tons of training, hundreds or thousands of hours of schooling, and not a single class on how to make a relationship work. That's why it's important for you to get trained and learn more about how to create that thing that ultimately will create, or arguably will create, the most fulfillment in your life, which is an intimate relationship and a family. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful. If it is, I'm gonna ask you, my dear, to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. If you click the little bell, you'll be notified of new episodes. Most important of all, if you want to go deeper on these concepts, I have created a masterclass for you. You click on the first line of the description of this video, enter your name and email, and you start watching that masterclass right away. Now, if you are more ambitious in nature and you are more tired of not getting what you want and you are more hungry to get it now versus 7 years from now, and you want my specific help, my decades of experience helping women find love to your advantage, you want to put my expertise to work for you, then the second link on the description of this video will allow you to click on the link, enter an application, name, email, a few other questions, and then if I feel I can help you, I'll connect with you. My assistant will reach out and connect with you so that we can figure out if we can be a mutual fit to work together and help you enter the best and the healthiest relationship of your life. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and conscious life.